trophies away for Oates, haven't they?
Six, Paul Willis, Pat Wall.
Daddy squad member.
He hasn't even got to play me, yeah, trophy. I'll have to move up here.
So we've got our main event up. Good matchup. Martin Eisel against Liam Stanley. I'll just commentate this until my food comes. So Martin at the table, electing to take reds. Martin's a steady player. Always runs deep into the competition. I don't think I've seen him less than top 8, top 16 in the in all the comps that he's entered. So nice finish there by Martin. First frame on the board. Probably see Liam just try and slow Martin up throughout this match. Liam's got the all-round game, to be fair. He can take a clearance out if needed. He can take cover. Bit of a slap break there from Liam. Never really crunched the balls. He has got a ball down. He's got a red down. Interesting what he takes here. He's going to take yellows. He's I've been running this off the red, just bump the red out away from the other yellow. Now he's I think he's missed that opportunity. I'd have definitely tried to flick it off that red. It just opens up that yellow. He's still got the one to the right middle. He has got a slight angle on this, to be fair. He's tried flicking that red, that yellow again. He knows it's a trouble ball. He definitely knows it's his trouble ball. Now Martin. He'd probably have a stab at these. As he's looking to try and take this one to the right middle. He'll be opening up all the other balls. He just hasn't got that cue ball up, but trying his hardest to manufacture a shot here to get down and split these little cluster up. I don't know whether this red slides past the yellow cushion, back of the yellow. He could even try and get the bag here. Definitely keeps him in the frame, that shot. So Liam himself has got a little bit of work to do here. But if there's anybody that knows how to get himself out of trouble, it's Liam. Liam could even take the opportunity to move this yellow out now. Obviously, the two reds by the black don't really go anywhere. I So as long as Liam don't leave Martin a manufacturing shot. And he's definitely stopped that. Covering the one to the bottom left so as Martin couldn't screw into these couple of balls in the middle of the table. So half decent shot there by Liam. He hasn't fully got that yellow out into realistically open play, but he's giving himself something to think about. Got any problems with sound or anything like that, just let me know. I can knock down the commentating mic. I can up the table mic. Bit of a strange one there by Martin. So, Liam needs to leave himself the double. He's got no alternative but to go for these. Liam hasn't any kind of containing shot here. Ain't gonna be much good. And you know he's just overrun that. I do now think that Liam's in a world of trouble on this frame. Got one shot on air, he's got to play this pacey. He's to play the one top left. Play plenty of top on the cue ball. The cue ball's going to straighten up, run round the two angles around the top right hand corner pocket. White's naturally going to throw itself back down towards that yellow. Playing this playing ball, he ain't gonna get this white moving. If he plays his playing ball, and that's what he's attempted. I think he's just put too much pace into that.
Yeah.
So we're getting another opportunity here for Martin to go 2-0 up. He's just got to find his pattern to get round this yellow that's in the bottom left-hand corner pocket. So a nice little angle here just to just stun this red in. No, he's elected to drop it in. And there it is, 2-0 to Martin.
Table 11, Steve Dowdell, Steve Morris. Table 11. Halliday, Cole Bromley, Wayne Callers, top table.
So that was confidence for your boy Martin Heisel, leaving his bad ball till last. Puts him 3-0 up. Liam's got a lot of work here. I don't think he's found his form yet this morning.
On table 7, Jason Ford, Ollie Bow.
Thank you.
two balls in a row.
So I am back after having a quick bite to eat. Some reason this weekend I've picked up a dodgy throat and the snuffles. So if you hear me cough or anything, I do apologise. I'm now down in the West Midlands, down by myself. We've had a bit of snow, so that's nice to be driving back home to later on today. Up here in Manchester, it's just bitterly cold. We've had no snow, so. But I do believe yesterday that junction 10 and 11 of the M6 was closed between them two junctions, which is not ideal because I have to go past them. I have to get off at junction 9. Ugly table at the moment. Liam just trying to keep himself in the match by taking control of a bag or two. But good opportunity here for Martin. Try and force this yellow down the side rail. The way he's queuing this, he's just going to drop it down there. Don't really give him much advantage of that pocket. Martin was trying to play there, but Liam's got to do something here. I can see this being a long drawn out frame. Liam won't rush. Trying to get full advantage of the of this one. Bit of a strange shot there by Liam. He's just he could have easily opened up this this bottom pocket then. I don't was going to say, I didn't think this yellow square was past this this red. Liam, look, then, as how that's turned out, I don't think it's turned out. I just think he's he's played across the ball. Trying to squeeze his pass. He's got it out. So I think he'll just drop this white behind this other yellow. He's got to make sure he doesn't leave any of those to the middle. That's a good shot. Definitely makes his frame more interesting now. It is amazing how these guys' knowledge of the game, just one shot, can turn the frame to the an advantage. Hazel was in trouble earlier on in this frame. He's manufactured a couple of shots. Now he's fully got control of it. So without not being completely close to the table, I don't know whether Martin's got a touching ball or not. He's really having a think about this one. He's already scratched his head. Got to get this white anywhere by the blue spot, brown spot, whatever he likes. So just don't think he wanted to get that close to the yellow. He's okay. He's just checking where he wants to leave the cue ball. Just needs to dink this in. And there we have 4-3 to Martin. He's definitely shown up this morning, Martin has.
A.D. Young, Lee Ross, table 15.
about half an hour ago.
I just changed.
There was trying to manufacture his reds out. I've just been told up here in Manchester we're expecting a flurry of snow. The end where I live, apparently we're expecting again more snow at around about 11 o'clock. So it makes myself, Matt Ward the ref, Neil Toms, his lovely lady, the guys that travelled up this weekend, an interesting drive home, as we don't know what to expect. On behalf of myself and the organisation, we'd like to thank everybody that's turned up throughout the year. Obviously the people that work hard behind the scenes, our referee Matt Ward, even though he plays on the tour, he still runs around, cleans the tables down, gets them ready for the next matches. And anything else that players request from him. Also Deb Toms, she does a lot of work behind the scenes as well. While Neil Toms himself plays, she organises the matches out and everything else. Bob Love deals with all payments and deals with players' requests. So yeah. A big thank you to each and every one of them. Without the likes of those people, Pearl just won't really take off. That's a bad shot there by Liam. To be fair, it's no harm done. So it's a good opportunity here for Martin to take control of this bottom corner pocket. Apply the deliberate foul. Just leave. No shot on. for Liam. So he's wasting his first shot. As he's still got one bad ball on the side rail. Black's tied up. I just feel would help in this matchup for Martin. But let's see how he goes about it. I think that's the correct shot there. As he left fell snooker. And by the way, Liam's pointed. He has left fell snooker. Nominated the red over the corner pocket. Oh, Liam, what you doing? You need to be screwing into those to get that white out. Seemed a little bit of a half-hearted shot that was then by Liam. So we can take this one to the right middle. Again, just drift down. Right middle, top right. Stun the one into the top left. Just run the white past the red, which is just above the black, for the black into the bottom right-hand corner. I would like to say this is formal for Liam, but he just really has not found his stride this morning for some reason. If he takes these out, maybe it'll give him a little bit of confidence getting a frame on the board. That's a good shot. Very good shot. Just needs to jack his cue up a little bit now. He's got to be careful leading off to middle. Playing that shot. Yeah, he's realising he's digging down a little bit deeper. So Liam managing to get his first frame on the board. Hopefully that settles him into the match.
all moved quite a lot, believe it or not, but then they always come back together again.
Not really, how are you, Bill?
So definitely a good chance here for Martin to close out this match. Is he going to attempt to flick this this blackout? He's got it. He's definitely opened it up. So you can take this one to the right middle. Take the one to the top right. Just leave yourself the right angle where you can pop this yellow and roll the white between the reds. You could even roll the white off the three reds for the black to the right middle. He has got a slight few options here. So this is the key shot here, it's making sure he leaves himself the correct angle. So he's looking at just stunning the white across, just slightly above the brown spot as we look. Delicate shot here. Oh, he's got it all wrong. He's got it all wrong. This is a dangerous shot, this is, because if he flicks this red, the white is naturally going to go down to this bottom left-hand corner. Oh, he's got lucky. He's hit it full ball. And there you go. Congratulations, Martin Eisel. Advances into the next round. Commiserations, Liam Stanley. Played well all weekend. So, guys, we just get the table cleaned down, ready for the next match. So, I'll see you all shortly.